Hi, welcome to Open Ed 21. I'm Lee Miller, and I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the Open Education Instructional Journal that I created as my capstone for the SPARC Open Education Fellowship Program. Let's get started. When I first started looking at what I wanted to do for the capstone, I knew I wanted to solve a problem. I wanted to create something that was going to benefit open education in general and instruction overall. So when I started looking closer at what we do here at the Center at Barton Community College and how we support faculty, I specifically wanted to look at how we support new faculty and those that come from industry. When looking closer at how we hire in higher education, I recognized that we hire specifically on knowledge and expertise in a specific discipline and not necessarily always on teaching experience or teaching practice knowledge. This was the gap I wanted to fill. That was the problem I wanted to solve. The solution, or a solution, that I wanted to offer faculty was what I ended up calling the Open Educational Instructional Journal. Inside, I have three different sections with five different categories apiece that are broke up into small bite-sized pieces that allow a faculty member to move through to gain some general knowledge around instructional practices with an OER First Approach that may ease their transition into academia if they haven't taught before or are coming from industry. Let's take a deeper look at the journal itself. So as soon as I had identified a project that I was going to do, I had to decide how I was going to do it. And structure was the next problem I had to overcome. With the structure of this, how do you take something as complex as education, and higher education nonetheless, and bring it down into a bite-sized digestible piece that faculty can move through while they're doing a whole bunch of other stuff? With this in mind, I wanted to create some organization as well as help them move forward in what they had to do and create their class at the exact same time. So the structure of this, as I indicated earlier, is three sections, five categories, which are the foundational, understanding and applying, and then innovation and connections. This is just progressive in the direction of how a faculty member can explore different topics and then use those same topics to end up moving through other sections of the journal itself. The categories for each one of these sections is instructional goals, course design, open education, student outcomes, and value added. When you look at instructional goals specifically, this is specifically for the instructor. What is it that they want to achieve for their class or classes? When we look at course design, this is looking at pedagogy and other teaching practices that may help them create their classes as well as have better outcomes and different opportunities that they may not necessarily know about yet. Open education is obviously the OER first approach, and this will explore general information on OER, but then also move into open pedagogy and other connecting features around open education in general. And then student outcomes is going to focus specifically on the student and how they can interact with the content and other opportunities that they may have to explore during a course. And then finally is value added. I wanted something that was going to add that little bit of extra that we talk about in education, but there's not necessarily a category for. And that's where this falls. Let's look a closer look at each section. So before I start, I might add that with each of the sections, there is a supplemental packet, a Word document, that coordinates with each one of the sections. So a faculty member can take the document and actually note some of the ideas and how they'd like to apply some of the concepts as they move through the journal itself. The first section that we're going to go through is the foundational section. And the first category is the instructional goals, where we literally look at the instructor's philosophy, if they haven't set one yet, and then what are their goals for their class or classes. The next is course design. And we specifically look at different highlights that allows them the opportunity to apply exactly what they're learning and what intrigues them that's going to coordinate well with their class. Open education, again, this is an OER first approach, so we're going to literally look at OER basics to start off so that they can take some of those concepts and apply them immediately into your class, and obviously look at where their content may fit and how they can use OER, and then how does that affect how they teach their class as well. And then we'll look at student outcomes, and this is specifically looking at the student experience and how the students are going to not only experience the class, but then reflect on their experience and apply what they're learning. And then last but not least, the value-added section for this, or the value-added category for this section, is specifically just defining it for the audience so that they know what to expect in the future sections. So the next section is understanding and applying. Here we're applying what we talked about previously, and we're adding more to it as well as layering stuff on. So then for instructional goals, not only are we looking at what the instructor wants, but what they can provide for their students. So we look at submission options and how to give different types of feedback. And then that moves on into course design, where we actually explore some of the different pedagogies and teaching methods that can impact how they want to teach and reflect what their philosophy means to them and what they want to give to their students. And then open education, this is where we introduce open pedagogy. And in many times, there's different things that will overlap in this space. And so we explore what that may mean and how they can use different ones that are going to accommodate their needs. And then we look at student outcomes. And this is specifically directed towards the student, where they can look at self-assessment, how do they do peer review, and then how do they actually accept and apply instructional feedback. Finally, the value-added piece for this piece is essential skills. So how can we add something a little bit extra, especially for that specific field or discipline, that's going to help that student once they get into the workforce and give them the edge they need? So the last section is innovation and connections. And this is just really an opportunity for the instructor to explore additional academic innovations and where can they make different connections to what they've already learned, both within their class and with what they've learned in the journal. So when we talk about instructional goals, we move back to where they have created their teaching philosophy and set their instructional goals for those courses. And where are they at in those aspects? Given an opportunity to combine ideas and explore some of those ideas in different ways, and then just the encouragement to stay curious, both within different teaching methods, pedagogies, as well as how that may attach to their discipline itself. And then that moves right into course design, where we continue to combine some of those ideas, but also add this extra perspective of an interdisciplinary perspective because of all the content access that they have across any number of content areas that may overlap in some areas or run parallel, and they can apply those to their course content. Open education, we look at student agency, student and faculty advocacy, and then student as creators, specifically of where those can attach with what they've talked about or some of the aspects within open pedagogy that's discussed. Student outcomes look specifically at DEI and accessibility, as well as authentic assessment, which really runs into the value added piece, where we talk about academic integrity and what that means, and taking the positive view of that rather than the contract cheating or the penalizing type of perspective. Looking at proctoring and how does that affect the student or the class, and what are other ways or options that you may be able to use for that, as well as just the general reminder that students are people too. And recognizing that in some ways may help or change the way that you either give feedback or interact with some of your students. I realize I've just scratched the surface, but I hope you've taken away some ideas and I've sparked a little curiosity about how this journal can help you, your faculty, or even your future faculty. Please note that it is licensed under a CC BY NCSA license so that it can be adapted for whatever your institutional academic needs are. At the end of the journal, there's also a survey, so I'd love to hear about what your thoughts are, comments, or impact as to what the journal has done for you or for your faculty. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of Open Ed 21.